My name is Alistair McClymont. I'm very lucky to have represented these students because what I have learned in the last couple of weeks is that there is so much support out here in the community for migrants, and I've been inundated with emails and telephone calls from all sorts of people in the last several weeks providing support. And this is exactly what's happening, is that support is getting larger and larger once the community in this country realises what these students have to go through. I am a little bit disappointed that our pro-Donald Trump friends haven't turned up yet, because I think that would have been very appropriate as a reminder that what we're fighting for is not just potential deportation for 9 students, it's really the rights of all migrants in this country. And what has been happening from my perspective as an immigration lawyer is a gradual reduction in the rights that migrants have in this country, and it is exemplified by the way that the government is now treating these students, where the government now no longer treats migrants here as human beings. They are now an economic commodity, and what is of priority to the government now is now the export education industry, the schools who are making millions and millions of dollars every year out of students, often providing substandard education, and the agents who are employed and paid by the schools in India to basically lure students from India, from China, from other countries to New Zealand, frequently under false pretenses, take their money out of them, and then do everything they possibly can to get them back out of the country and replace them with somebody else with more money so that they can fill the pockets of these agents and the schools. And these are the people that the government now want to support, because these students are just simply an economic commodity. They're a number, they're a dollar value, they're no longer human beings, and this is the way that the government is now moving and treating all migrants, not just in students, but in workers, residents, this everybody. And this is an international trend that is happening, and it really has to stop. Now we need to draw the line in the sand, and the government now needs to know that New Zealand as a country and this community will not tolerate this, and that the migrants that are coming here are exactly the same as the New Zealand citizens. We all have the same dreams, we have the same hopes, we all have families that wish the best for us, we all have our future dreams and desires, and we want a best life for our children. We all want the same thing. We're all human beings, we are not an economic commodity. And I want to thank you for all your support, and I look forward to tell the government what we need. Thank you.